Good morning. Still early season in Super Rugby, but already the Kiwi teams are setting the standards with some remarkable rugby. I'm delighted to be joined in studio by ex-Wales and Lions legend Scott Quinnell and former Brumbies superstar Matt Tamua. Before we get their thoughts on this morning's game, let's remind you of what's happened so far in round seven. Excitement is building in Las Vegas. Before that, the new manager of Rangers. Hi there. We'll preview three matches in the Premier League as two teams pushing to break into the top six meet at Goodison. Now, the World Club Challenge Series takes place this Saturday. David Garr, good afternoon to you. David Root, widely expected to get this job, wasn't he? So no big surprise. Have the ECB got the right man, do you think?
Very likely, yeah.
We can cross live and speak to Orla Chennaoui, who's in Rio. Orla, you heard the explosion. What more do we know about the incident?
Yes, this took place just about 2 hours before the men's road race finished.
We heard a loud bang about 90 minutes ago. It was just behind me.
When we arrived at the ninth floor apartment of the shop, we were once again assured we could place an order.
If he had what he suspected to be foreign athletes coming in here next year to buy this supplement in particular, would he sell it?
Heute Abend sicherlich ein Glas Champagner genießen, aber nicht zu viele. Die Olympischen Spiele beginnen in weniger als 2 Wochen. Muss immer noch in Topform bleiben.
Mark Cavendish, Sir Bradley Wiggins, congratulations. That was epic.
Do you think we'll get to see you riding in the race?
Probably not, actually. Especially Brad has been super stressed, you know, and I think he wants to be the hero and all that.
Laura Trott, Jason Kenny, two of the most successful British athletes we have ever had.
Max Whitlock, Lewis Smith, congratulations.
Sir Chris Hoy, Chris, you said to me before these games got underway that we would see incredible success.
In the middle of an absolute scrum here, the man at the centre of that, the three-time Tour de France winner, Chris Froome, congratulations. You just come to the podium, emotions must be running quite high. How do you feel?
Oh, it's incredible, absolutely incredible. I mean, it really could just be the first time all over again.
Hopes for next year's Commonwealth Games may seem overly ambitious, and certainly conditions here are very different.
She reiterated her stance on doping, said she hates dopers, in her words. She hates what they have done to the sport.
The athletes I've spoken to, for the third missed test, they say they would become obsessive to make sure that didn't happen. How was that third missed test allowed to happen?
Yeah, I absolutely understand that, and I would be one of those athletes too saying that.
Well, we can tell you that play has once again been suspended at Augusta in the par three. Yeah, the course has been evacuated, hasn't it? Well, Ben Smith back from injury to take the captaincy once again, and he's made his mark today, hasn't he?
Didn't make that mistake again.
Fairly plain and simple, but that is the food of champions. In Rio de Janeiro, this is how to get around. Oh, he's taking a picture.
Probably 40 to 1.
40s,
you said you were going to give everybody sixes.
I said
so
no
if you want
to
bet
thing.
On you,
no such thing.
All I would give it. Fun Sky, 0207.
There was a familiar face amongst that lot as well. Jeff's suits obviously fit better these days.
His teeth are a bit whiter. I think he looks younger.
Younger now?
Yeah. What do you think? Sharp as you like. Jeff Stelling still a mainstay of Sky Sports. That is it from us. We've had a wonderful morning of Super Rugby here on Sky Sports. I very much hope you've enjoyed it too.
On all screens, on the go, and the best bits on demand.